old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. So you have no past reference, no past record to pull from. It doesn't exist. You do not have a past because your past has been canceled by God. Your past never happened. Say, my past never happened. Say it again. Say it again. I want you to say something, and I want you to say it slowly. I want you to say, everything is mine. One more time. One more time. Now see, I'm giving you the scriptures. This is not something that I'm saying. This is something God already said about you. Now you can put it behind me on the screen. 1 Corinthians 3:21. Therefore let no man glory in men, for all things are yours. All things are yours. All things. Say, all things, are mine. Say it again. Now close your eyes and say it again. Now that's very hard to grasp. That is the world I'm about to introduce to you. Absolute reality. And the Bible says, whether it's Paul or Apollos or Cephas, Peter, or the world, or life, or death, or things in the present, or things in the future, all things are yours. My, my. I want you to say that, even though it may be difficult for you to comprehend it at this moment, I want you to say, the world, say, the world is mine. Say it again. One more time, please. Did you hear what you said about yourself? I want you to also say, life is mine. Death is mine. The present is mine. The future is mine. All things are mine. It's the Bible. That is the word, and you cannot change one dot. All things are yours. Now, Paul, Apollos, or Peter are yours to nourish you. The world, the Bible says you'll judge. Life is yours eternally. Death, you'll overcome. The present, you'll rule. The future, you'll rule. Everything is yours. Now, many Christians cannot grasp this because it's too big of a promise. But you have to accept it as fact that the world that we live in as Christians has no limits. No limits. The world we see around us, the flesh, has limits.
But the world that's been promised to us has no limitation. Limitation is only known to the old life. Limitation is only known to the old man. And all limitations disappear in Jesus. All limitations disappear when he who is eternity lives inside of you. He who is eternity. God does not live in eternity. He is eternity. God doesn't live. He is life. I've said this many times. God does not exist. He is existence. And when he who is all life and eternity lives in me, then he brings that world that has no limits into my heart. And now everything is mine. Let no man glory in man. All things are yours, whether Paul, Apollos, Peter, the world, life, death, things present, things to come. All is yours, and you belong to Jesus, and Jesus belongs to God. Now, our faith, you as a believer, you have no past reference. You have no past track record. You have nothing to pull from. It doesn't exist. You have no past. You say amen, but you don't even get it. Because when you talk as though you have a past. Like, I don't do the things I used to do. What things that you used to do? Those things don't exist. I'm no longer the man I was. What man were you? You are not. You have no past. You did not exist. You are a new creation. Someone tap that girl. Tap her. Nobody sleeps in my meeting. If you're not sleeping, then open your eyes. I want to see them. No past. Say, I have no past. I own it. It's mine. Aha. All the things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. So you have no past reference, no past record to pull from. It doesn't exist. You do not have a past because your past has been canceled by God. Your past never happened. Say, my past never happened. Say it again. Say it again. So when you speak and say, well, when I used to do drugs, what did you say? You used to do drugs? No. There's no such thing as I used to, because you were not there. That did not exist. There is no past life. There is no past record. There is no past reference, because the past never took place. Now you say right now, it never happened. Say it again. One more time.
Now, Catherine Kuhlman got that message one day when she was young. It transformed her life and ministry when she realized that the only weapon the devil has against you is your past. And that's why the Bible says, take the weapon away from him, because there is no past. So when she was young, she married a guy, a pastor named Mr. Waltrip. Then she divorced him. 3 weeks later, she divorced him because of the convicting power of the Holy Spirit. She couldn't handle it, the conviction. She marries a man, he leaves his wife to marry her, then she divorced him. Yeah, that's double trouble. Now, it was bad enough to be a woman preacher back then, but to be a divorced woman preacher was big trouble. So now she's walking down a dead end road, literally dead end. It said, the sign said, dead end. And God dealt with her, and she repented. And when she repented, God spoke and said to Catherine Kuhlman, in my books, it never happened. Because you repented, in my books, it is erased. It is not there. I cannot find it in my books. It never happened. So she goes back into the ministry, begins to preach again. A woman comes and says to her, how dare you preach? You're a divorced woman. And Catherine's answer was classic. She said, oh, honey, that was someone else. That was somebody else. That Catherine died. I was never divorced because she was speaking scripture. Now you'd call that lie. It's not a lie when you live with no limits. People that confess old sins are not living in that world of no limits. Because all the things are passed away. Behold, all things are new. You are a new creation. There was no creation like you ever in the past. You are a brand new man. A new creation. Do you believe it? Yes or no? Then live it. You have to live it now. So I want you to say one more time, I have no past. No record, no reference to pull from. My past never happened. Never took place. Now that is Bible. Never, ever, ever any one of you say, I'm sorry for what I did. No, you did not do it. That was the old man. Jesus. And he's gone. Yeah. We are a new creation. You are what? Come on, one more time, talk to me. Say, I'm a new creation. I'm a brand new man. Brand new. My past never happened. Never took place. I have no past. No limits. Now it's time you get this in your heart, because when Jesus came into your hearts, the past disappeared. Now, Satan likes to go back to it, and you have to keep telling him, never happened, devil. You're a loser, devil. Never happened, devil. And when you begin to live that, victory will come to you like an explosion. Now, one more time. No limitation. No limitation. Say it again. No limitation. One more time. Now,
all you have to do is live in that new creation. Live in that life of the Spirit. Live in it and walk in it and have no limits.